Welcome friends, welcome to our Tech Management Education channel. We are running Six Sigma series, Black Belt full course in our present series of lectures. So already we have covered 8 lectures. This is our 9th lecture. In the last 8 lectures we have covered defined phase. Earlier what is Six Sigma, what is standard deviation, what is average and what is difference between average, standard. Then we have learned about CTQ, critical to quality, QFD and other aspects of defined phase. So please go through our earlier videos to get full knowledge of defined phase. So this is our final lecture on defined phase. Here we will cover up how to make a team for project, how to define finally how to define a project and how to make a project charter. So before measurement phase we need to freeze our project title and team, and we need to kick off our Six Sigma project. Okay. So for making a Six Sigma team we need at least 12-13 people for a project, typically for a Six Sigma project. So in that team, like we have drawn, there will be a champion, there will be a leader who will be the flag bearer of the Six Sigma project. He may be department head, he may be section head, he may be some functional head. Who is the responsibility, who is the P&L, profit and loss responsibility of that section and unit. So there should be a champion to guide the team, to facilitate the team with the resources on all these things. And time to time he will review the project. Okay. So there is a champion, and there should be one black belt who is black belt certified or trained for hand holding the team throughout the project journey. Okay. And there will be two green belt holders. Okay. He has a certain amount of knowledge of Six Sigma, carried out one or two projects earlier. Okay. So this is green belt, and these are members. They are fresh, and during the journey they will learn about Six Sigma, its methodology and other things, and subsequently they can become a green belt holder after completion of the project, like that. So this is a typical project team. So after finalizing the project team, there are various lot of exercises like voice of customer collection, survey and all these things. So after all these things, we need to formulate our project statement. Okay, so like project statement, we can have a different kind of approaches for projects, but all statements are not project statements, ideal project statements. Like one example, our customers are angry with and thus delay paying bills. This is a statement of a team that our customers are not satisfied and that's why they are not paying bills. So in that statement, there is no conflict. How much dissatisfaction level, what is the dissatisfaction level, there is no timeline. By when, by how many days they are delaying bills, what is the impact to our business, nothing is mentioned. So without data and without any specific values, our statement is not acceptable. Like we'll see how statements can be. Like in the last 3 months, 10% of our customers are late by over 30 days in paying bills. This represents 20% of our outstanding receivables and negatively affects our operating cash flow. In the statement, there is a time period, when, what is the duration of the issue, like last 3 months, okay, and who are our customer, 10% of our customers, and what is the main problem? Main problem is paying bills, over 30 days in paying bills, delay in paying bills. What is the magnitude, which is 20% of our outstanding receivables. So it's a huge 20% receivables, it's a huge magnitude. So this is a serious problem. It can be a Six Sigma project. Okay, if anything affects beyond 10% of our business, it is very much ready for a Six Sigma project. And which negatively affects our operating cash flow. Okay, this is the consequence. We are not receiving money, so this is affecting our cash flow. So here, when, what, magnitude, consequence, everything should be mentioned in a statement. Okay. So this is our similar way we can define other projects. Like in a plant, if some efficiency to be improved. So problem statement cannot be like that. We need to improve efficiency of our plant. It can be like that. We need to improve our efficiency from 10% to 15% within 3 months, which will give us a revenue benefit of say 50,000 rupees per month. Okay, so similar kind of, there should be timeline, there should be specific seriousness of the problem, how much we need to upgrade and what will be the monetary benefit. So this kind of definition we need to formal, we need to build, so that our management is will be keen to know what is the problem, what is the depth of the problem, and how much benefit I am going to get after completion of this project. Because every Six Sigma project has to have some monetary gain. Otherwise, without monetary gain, no management will approve Six Sigma project. Okay. So in this way, we can formalize a project statement. After lots of CTQ, QFD, and sort of brainstorming process, voice of customer collection, everything. So finally, we need to collect what is our statement, and how we need to build our statement in a way it is having everything. Like what is the problem, what is the magnitude, and by when we are going to address it, and after addressing it, what will be my benefit. Okay. So after making the team and project statement, we will make a project charter. Project charter will be like this. There are so here will be team details, then project statement. Okay, and value addition. After project. Okay, verified by finance. Okay, our team details. Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 12 members. Okay, project statement, then value addition after project or gain. Gain. Okay. Then tagline. Okay. Then our plant head, champion. So this is a project charter, and after project charter, this has to be approved by our management, like our champion, plant head, or CFO, or whoever is this. So they should be approved. Okay. So for that, we need to then. So this is a project charter. So our project finalization and project benefit should be very clear, and it should be very attractive to our management. Then only they will approve our process, approve our project, and finally project kickoff. So after everything we have decided, project charter and taken approval from management and other things. So there will be a project kickoff meeting. So we can invite our business head or kind of thing, and all cross-sectional departments who will be the involved in this project execution. So in that, there will be a brief by top management to all that what will be the benefit of this project. So they will be seeking, assistance or help from other cross-functional departments. So this kind of thing will get due attraction from all section of the employee, so that it will be executed in a phased manner, and there will be no obstacles from any one in the section of the area. Okay. So after kickoff meeting, we will start our next level of journey, like manage measurement and other aspects. Okay. So this is the in broad defined phase. So in defined phase, we have learned what is Six Sigma, what is standard deviation, how it is different with average. Then we have learned CTQ finalizing, QFD finalization. Then our team formation. Then we need to define our project properly. After that, we will prepare a project charter. It will it will have team details, project details, financial benefit details. Then finally, approval of all our CFO and project plant management team. After doing everything, we'll have a formal kickoff meeting to start the project, and then we'll progress with analysis and other things. So in the next lecture, we'll start our second phase, which is measurement phase. So friends, thank you for viewing. So hope you are learning and enjoying. See you in next lecture. Thank you.